using the strength of the sun's rays to supply energy grids, powering airplanes with plants and waste, creating a source of near limitless energy that mimics the stars in the sky. These all might sound like science fiction concepts, but they're becoming increasingly real and important in the fight against climate change. The growing field of climate technology is offering some solutions to the problem through innovation and science.
So climate technology can be thought of as a variety of solutions that are meant to help limit the impacts of humans on climate and reduce climate change as we go forward. One way is to try to directly limit humans' largest influence on the climate system, which is the emissions of carbon dioxide gas, or CO2.
This can be done by trying to reduce the amount of emissions being spewed out into the atmosphere, using tech like renewable energy. It can also be done by sucking the carbon out of the atmosphere, by planting trees. They might try to reduce overall energy consumption, for example, switching to LED lights. Other tech helps us adapt to a changing planet, like engineering hardier crops. Then there's technology that helps us better understand and monitor our changing planet. These technologies are on the rise, aided by an increased public awareness, funding from government,
the science is devastatingly clear,
and from venture capital companies like Evergreen Climate Innovations.
The reason we came about was because there was a dramatic funding gap going towards clean energy and climate technologies.
Although private funding of climate technology hit a peak of $40 billion in 2021, he thinks more can be done. The types of innovations considered climate tech is now more diverse than ever, too.
Clean energy is still very relevant, but we are now looking at technologies in water. We're looking at technologies involving agriculture. We're looking at technologies involving the circular economy, recycling and reuse.
With thousands of climate technologies, businesses and concepts to choose from, which offer the most potential in the fight against climate change? According to projections from the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, wind and solar energy will be the most essential technologies for reducing emissions by 2030. The cost of solar and wind energy have plummeted in the past few decades, often making them more affordable than running fossil fuel factories. Both technologies are also easily scalable. You can have a solar panel the size of a backpack, install a few on a residential rooftop, or build an entire solar farm. Another technology that could have a big impact on climate change by 2030 is carbon sequestration through farming. When plants and crops grow, they capture CO2 from the air and store it in the soil around them. Converting natural habitats into farmlands can slow down this process, causing carbon from the soil to be released back into the air. One sequestration technology is biochar. The char is created from burning leftover biomass in a controlled way. Biochar contains a stable form of carbon from the biomass that can stick around in the soil for a long time. It also improves crop yield and has been used for thousands of years by many indigenous groups in the Amazon. Those technologies are set to have the biggest impact until 2030. But what happens after that when newer tech might come to the market? For Mr. Burkitz, one vital piece of tech that still needs innovation is batteries.
Long-lasting, fast-charging batteries in vehicles. You need long-lasting, long-duration batteries tied to the grid to store energy to then use at a later point in time. There is still a lot of money and research and innovation taking place in sort of the energy storage sector.
He says that innovation is needed in all parts of the battery industry, from production right down to disposal. Another technology to watch, according to Mr. Burkitz, is hydrogen power.
Carbon-free production, it burns cleanly. It's very versatile as a fuel.
Hydrogen can be produced by renewable energy, and as a fuel, it stores three times more energy than traditional petrol, with the only byproduct being water. Innovation is desperately needed in this industry, as hydrogen is a tricky fuel to work with and is currently very expensive.
It's a gas, it's a molecule that's very difficult to work with. It's very slippery. It tends to leak and escape from pipelines and other storage mediums.
Dr. Bernhardt also mentioned the rise of direct carbon capture as a buzzy new industry.
while it's still all in its infancy, certainly there's a lot of promise that seems the ability to capture CO2 from, say, a power plant before it goes into the atmosphere and then starts influencing the climate.
Carbon capture can also be implemented directly, sucking carbon straight out of the air. It can either be buried or turned into useful end products. In its current form, though, this tech doesn't make a real impact on global emissions. It also raises ethical eyebrows.
The proverbial band-aid to just try to capture and store the CO2 we've got off is limiting the emission, lowering them.
One massive breakthrough from December 2022 saw scientists in California create a nuclear fusion reaction, which gave off more energy than it took to trigger it. The fusion reaction is a huge step forward for clean power, with the potential to produce almost limitless amounts of energy, giving off no greenhouse emissions and producing no radioactive waste. The process is very logistically challenging, though, and research into fusion will have to continue for years to come before the technology could become commercially viable. From frequent technological breakthroughs to increased funding, climate tech is a growing field. So can it save the planet? Definitely not alone.
There are organizations and people that are working on policy and advocacy issues. There are people who are working on educating people and changing consumer behavior. There are organizations and people working on land conservation. Those are really, really important issues and approaches to addressing climate.
Without them, nothing gets done.